Our new stars for Club Life 2008 are Aberdeenshire, who combine great facilities with big ambitions, Lynton and Lynmouth from Devon, who play in one of the most stunning settings in the country, and the proud and passionate London-based side, Catford Wanderers.
Hidden amid the spectacular rugged coastline of the Exmoor National Park in North Devon lie the beautiful twin towns of Lynton and Lynmouth. The dramatic Valley of Rocks is the stage for one of the most beautiful cricket grounds in the country. Founded in 1876, Lynton and Lynmouth is steeped in history. Here, though, is the class of 2008. Leading from the front as opening batsman and skipper is farm labourer Gary Jones. Carpet fitter Ed Yeo is also a hard hitter. Constructor Steve Hobbs is a destructive batsman. Laid back to the point of falling over is plumber and all-rounder Nick Bowen. Student Sam Shake is a classical batsman. In between jobs, Mark Jones is an effective off-spinner. Builders labourer Ben Fitt is an aggressive, genuine all-rounder. Vice-captain Matt Ryan is MD of a local holiday company. Cockney decorator Matt Faulkner is a live wire in the field. Great hands with both scalpel and bat is consultant surgeon Steve Hunt. Star of the future is off-spinner Harry Chapman Walker. And finally, we have Graham Fitt, an ardent follower of the team with a wise head. Promoted last year, Lynton and Lynmouth have a tough season ahead in the North Devon top flight.
It's a difficult league, Division 1. It's a different kettle of fish entirely, to be honest with you. The teams come from a lot further away. They include some very high-quality players, overseas players. One of the sides that we'll be competing against has just had one of the fast bowlers signed up by Warwickshire. So it'll be tough for us. They take their cricket very seriously. They play it very hard. We tend not to take it seriously enough at times. But we've got some talented players. And if everybody comes together, I think we'll upset a few people.
Whilst the setting is spectacular, there are some downsides.
Goats. One of the biggest problems this club suffers is goats. Mountain goats that get on the pitch, wreak havoc basically, and now we've had ponies introduced as well, which are obviously very popular with the tourists and holidaymakers, but they do cause us some severe problems.
And there were more difficulties afoot for the Lynton players as this year's pre-season get-together took an unusually strenuous format.
We decided to go along with the boot camp theme and get together, muck in, get wet, and try and stay out of the pub as long as possible.
Miles into the walk and an hour late, skipper Gary Jones arrived. He had a decent excuse though. His farm was in the middle of the lambing season. Jones wouldn't miss out on the team's activities for the world. He loves being part of the club.
They are a great bunch of lads, a bit lively at times, a bit boisterous, but the youngsters, that's what it's all about. Got some good cricketers there, a couple really good cricketers. And a couple of us oldies try and keep them in order. Well, I think we might surprise a few people. As I said, we've got two or three really good cricketers. Probably our fielding, a few of us a little bit slower in the field now, so we might lose a little bit there. But batting and bowling, I think we'll hold our own with most of them.
After 8 miles and 4 hours of exhaustion, the boys arrive back into the sanctuary of the pub. It had been a long day, with undoubtedly a long night to follow. Next morning, the team gathered, having had little time for rest following their exertions.
Matt had an idea to try and get everyone together at the start of the year. To get on some little walk. Unfortunately, it was about minus 20 degrees. The wind was blowing a gale. So, well, I mean, it was all right to see everyone, but I don't know, we could have been doing some paintballing or something like that.
It was nice to see the lads. Haven't seen them all winter. And, well, it's just nice to meet up with them before you meet them in the changing room. On the first game, it's nice to meet them first and just kind of get all the what you've been doing over the winter out of the way, and then you can get on and play cricket.
That first game was a cup match against Holsworthy Cricket Club. And after winning the toss and deciding to bowl, the home side got off to a flyer, courtesy of Graham Fitt.
Oh.
slow start by the visitors led to some confusion over the scores. Holsworthy regrouped and some brave batting gave the Lynton skipper plenty to ponder. The innings ebbed and flowed. Holsworthy eventually finishing on a respectable 172 for 6 from their 45 overs. After tea, the run chase got underway, and despite an early blow, the home side never looked to be in too much trouble as runs came aplenty. And as evening fell on the Exmoor coast, the target was successfully reached, leaving the Lynton boys to celebrate a comfortable victory and a great start to the season. And man of the match, Graham Fitt, was full of praise.
It's a great way to start, morale boosting, just everyone's in good spirit, and hopefully it'll lead us on to have a very good season in Division 1 this year.
Well, it's not a bad start for our clubs, is it? One rained off, understandably up in Aberdeen there. Two wins, so that's a good start. And it's normally at this stage that we have to adopt a club each, isn't it? Mm. You're going for Aberdeen?
Yeah, I think I'll go Aberdeen, because if it does rain up there, there's plenty of fishing. So we can wander off and do a bit of that.
Yeah, you don't want to play any cricket, do you?
No, I'm not playing cricket, no. No, so I'll probably live nearest to Aberdeen out of all of us, yes.
Comfortably.
So. Comfortably, yeah. So I'll go Aberdeen then.
OK. Bumble?
I wanted Lynton and Lynmouth. I've been to that ground. It's absolutely fantastic. It is so special.
Very, very scenic,
out for holidays,
yeah.
There. David, yep. Shepherd lives down the road from there, umpire David Shepherd. But having seen the three teams and Lynton and Lynmouth, I thought, yeah, that's me. I've got to go there. I've got to go for the old geezers. I really have. The old fellas. I'll go for them. Catford Wanderers. Yeah. Well, number one, they've got a dog track at Catford, which is round the corner. And the big one. What about the big one? Ganesh. He's not missed many lunches, has he?
Yeah. Saw him through to victory. When you say the old ones, how old are you? So I asked you the other day, didn't I?
Yeah, I was 45 the other day. I'm 47 today.
I think you'll find you're still marginally the senior of some of those, or most of those players there at Catford.
Well, I think I'd better go for Catford. I'll go for Catford for the old fellas out of curiosity.
Were you impressed with the hammer and the paintwork and the side screens
Everything pointed me to Catford, yeah. Yeah, I think I'd be well at home down at Catford there.
All right, so we worked it out, the morals here. You're going to Aberdeen because when it rains you go fishing. You're going to Catford when it rains you can go and watch the dogs.
Yeah.
And what am I going to do in Lynton? I'll just go boating off the
It's lovely.
Off the coast.
Oh,
there.
It's gorgeous. It's right.
Or maybe
up
take
your
up goat
street.
Farming.
Yes, get some goats. Have you got some goats?
No, not at the moment. No. It's a busy summer anyway without looking after goats. But the problems, the unique problems of our clubs around this country, worrying about sort of feral goats and ponies is different.
It's the goats that's the problem here. All over the show.
It's not a question of coaching, the pitch, talent, all the rest of it. It's the goats.
That's it. Well, you can have the goats and the ponies. Yeah. You got horses? Have you got horses?
No, not near enough land.
Okay.
So stay away from those ponies. All right, well, we will be following all those three very, very closely throughout the summer, and as we can see, we're going to enjoy that. OK, Friends Provident Trophy. If you've already had-